يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين
تقال العثار العظام به ويعود الهوى ككبش ذبيح بذكر الإله.
I'm not that religious. I don't want to be like these people. They all look religious, but you know, really, they're just scum, and they're cheaters and liars and all of that. I don't want to deal with them, etc., etc. I know what they're all like, etc. Fine, you're not Islamic. You call yourself normal. I don't want to be the religious type. Cool, good for you. Except when it's to your advantage. So when your son is acting up, you start quoting. You know, in Islam, you have to be good to your mom. When did Islam just? Mom just got religious? No, mom didn't get religious. Just religion served her purpose right now. So she quoted it. Or the husband who doesn't even pray, drinks, whatever else, you know, abusive. And the wife speaks up, you know, in Islam, women are supposed to be obedient.
Islam? Really? You? Islam?
When do you quote Islam? When you can slap somebody with it. This is tu'minuna bi ba'd al-kitab wa takfuruna bi ba'd. Now this part of the Sharia is very beloved to me. Everything else about Sharia, who cares? Truly, if I truly acknowledge this about myself and you acknowledge this about yourselves, if we don't become people that when we pray, when we stop and pray and we recite Allah's words, that we don't give up our own pride, ego, insistence, addiction. You and I have certain sins, we're doing some things wrong, and we don't want to let go of that wrong. We're afraid of letting it go. It's too dear to us, it's too sweet to us, it's too compelling to us. And when we're standing in front of Allah, we're telling Allah, Ya Allah, I'm willing to pray for you, I'm willing to recite Quran, I'm willing to do all this other good, but let me just hold on to this sin. I don't want to let go of this. Okay, I'll make up for it with all this other good stuff. وَأَحَاطَتْ بِهِ خَطِيئَتُهُ. Somebody who earned a single sin, and that mistake took a hold of him, it surrounded him. Like you start negotiating with Allah, I'll give you all this other ibadah, but this one, two, three haram things, let me just hold on to them, okay? I'm not dealing with that. At first you maybe even make istighfar for it, eventually you stop even making istighfar for it. Allah knows how I am. At least I do all this other good stuff. This is أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. Believing in some parts of the book, rejecting, denying, ignoring other parts of the book. And so I conclude with the scary conclusion that Allah Himself gives. May Allah protect all of us. He says, what should be the compensation for somebody who does that among you? Except khizyun fil hayatid dunya, humiliation in this worldly life. Wa yawm al qiyamati yuradduna ila ashadd al adhab. And on the day of resurrection, they will be taken, rejected and taken back to the most intense of all punishment. When they take part of the book and they reject other parts of the book, they make the book itself look ugly. They make Islam look ugly. And for so many other people who could have come to Islam, when they see their behavior, they walk away from Islam. As a matter of fact, even their own younger generation says, my parents acted in this way. My uncles acted in this way. They were religious in this, but look at how they behaved in this. I want nothing to do with Islam. You were the reason to push Shaitan's agenda onto your own, to spread kufr within your own. What bigger crime is there?